This Holland Crusade is truly historic. The greatest crowds ever in Europe's history to receive the gospel face to face. Police claim that from 120 to 150,000 were gathered on the Malieveld grounds tonight. There were at least 100 policemen present. I don't know how many scores of Red Cross nurses and staffmen, stretchers and trucks were on duty. They've gathered all spare wheelchairs, stretchers, and cots from this entire area. To watch them was like watching an ambulance corps on a battlefield, serving the wounded and the helpless. The papers, radio, and TV are all favorable in their news coverage. The pastoral committee has been rather uneasy about the chief of police, who has been quite demanding on us. They thought he might be looking for technical reasons to curtail the campaign. But today the committee secretary was summoned to the office of the chief of police, who had also gathered together a large number of his top policemen. Before them all, he told his men how he believed that this was of God, that he was very, very thankful that such a meeting and such wonders of God could take place in his city, Holland's capital, The Hague. It seemed almost unprecedented to me the way this nation is doing everything possible to make the campaign a great success. Tonight I preached on John 3:16 and verse 17. Never have we seen a mass of people more attentive. Literally thousands accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior and were born again when we invited them to decide for Christ. Then we prayed for the great mass of people, and miracles of healing were everywhere. There's no way I could convey the glory of this meeting. A girl who was 90% blind was completely healed. A fine man who had a severe back injury, a cancer on his nose, and a double rupture was perfectly healed of all three. The cancer simply vanished. No sign of it remained. His back was as free as a child's, and both ruptures disappeared. A woman who had been in a wheelchair for 21 long years was perfectly healed. During the message, she just got up and began to walk and was made entirely whole. Then she ran to the platform to show everyone how she could run and even jump. Then a funny thing happened. When she went down from the platform, she couldn't find her wheelchair. At the hotel that night, a government information agency man told me that he had seen her running all about everywhere, and she was so happy, but looking for her wheelchair and couldn't find it. A lad took off the steel braces from his legs, which had been paralyzed by polio. He walked back and forth on the platform to show that his legs were perfectly healed. A man on two crutches was marvelously healed and came across the platform carrying his crutches on his shoulder to show what God had done. Another man who could only walk with the aid of two canes was healed. He too came rejoicing, carrying and waving his canes. A woman in a wheelchair got up and was healed. She was so happy. A lady was healed of cancer in the breast. It was gone. Another woman was healed of a hernia. A man was healed of asthma. An old woman, totally blind, was carried to the crusade in a wheelchair. That dear old lady was completely healed. She really raised a shout in the camp when her blind eyes came open, and then she got out of her wheelchair and began to walk normally. She could see everything clearly and could walk as good as ever. It was really amazing because she was a real heavy woman. Oh, there were scores of other marvelous miracles. And as usual, hundreds raised their hands in the audience saying that they were healed but couldn't get up to the platform. Holland can never forget this day and never can be the same again.
February 21st, 1959, Lomé, Togoland.
Tonight I feel more amazed over this campaign than ever before. It's among the greatest. Such power, such conversions, such miracles. Every day, more and greater miracles are taking place. As far as conversions, there never seems to be anyone who refuses to accept Christ in the whole crowd. It's mass conversion and mass healing, literally. Tonight I preached on acting faith. Four lepers claim complete healing tonight. Two of them had sores all over their hands and feet. In a few days, all of those sores have dried up. One of them had the type of leprosy where all his flesh burned like fire. Now his flesh never burns and he feels well. The other was the painful type, and she is free of all pain. An old lady who was totally blind for 5 years was healed tonight and could count fingers of people standing out in the audience. Then there was a girl who had been carried by her father from a faraway village. For some years she had not walked a step. Tonight she could run and jump like any girl. A young man was carried by his father to the meeting from a distant area. He had been unable to walk for about 6 years. He had tried all of the native fetishes and witch doctors, but to no avail. Then he heard about the campaign, and his father carried him here. He was completely healed tonight and just smiled and wept and rejoiced so much as he testified. Another young man was healed who had been bedfast for 3 years. From far away in his village, he had heard about the campaign. He said he heard that the Son of God had come down to earth and was healing the people. I told him that was right, but that I was not the Son of God, that his name is Jesus. He understood and was marvelously converted too. This poor man had been vomiting blood as often as 20 times a day. He was dying of tuberculosis. Over 100 miles up in the interior, he had heard of the miracles. He had been bedfast for 3 years and could not walk. He had no voice. His parents were so poor that they only had enough money to pay an old truck driver to carry him to the capital city of Lomé. They knew if he was not healed, he would die anyway. If he was healed, he could walk home. They carried him to the old truck, paid the fare, and put him in the care of the driver who helped him during the trip. Upon arrival in Lomé, the truck driver carried him and laid him on the ground under a tree near the platform. He had a few precious coins with which he bought some rice from a woman who occasionally went to the grounds. 3 days he had lain there, and tonight he was healed. As he testified, his voice grew stronger. He was one of the happiest, most wonderful persons I've ever seen. Is not the Lord's mercy unfailing? We feel so awed to think that he has allowed us to be his instruments to bring the gospel to these dear people here in Togoland. Over 50 towns and villages have already sent invitations begging us to come preach the gospel to them or send someone in our place. It's so touching to hear different people testify of coming from so far, then to hear them begging us to come or to send a preacher to them. Another chief sent a letter and is even here in the audience begging us to send preachers to his people who believe this gospel. One man testified whose right leg was smaller than the other and was stiff. Now he's well and the leg is normal. An old man was healed of total blindness. A young man was perfectly healed of a deaf ear. A woman was healed of a large rupture and just cried out with joy. My man is so proud of me now. My man is so proud of me now. It's truly amazing what God is doing in Togoland.
February 6th, 1960, Lucknow, India.
I take up my pen to try to set down what my eyes have beheld on the second night of the Lucknow India Crusade. Words are inadequate to record the glory of the meeting. Early in the afternoon, the people were crowding onto the grounds near the stadium. By 6 p.m. when I arrived, the multitude was packed tight and stretched far out across the field, past our large light installation, out into the darkness. Officials estimated 50 to 75,000 people were present at least. They were so reverent and orderly. Not once did we have any difficulty controlling the multitude. No one could imagine the looks on the people's faces here in India. Some of the strange characters present were beyond description. For example, right in front of the platform, not 3 feet from me, there stood an old Hindu holy man in a filthy robe. His long, dirty white beard and his frizzy, flea-infested hair shrouded a desperate and pitiful face. Yellow paint was smeared on his forehead. Mixed mud and dust covered his face and hair. He was standing erect, and in his right hand was a large Father Neptune-type iron spear with prongs, which remained right by his face in height, with the other end resting on the ground. It was his staff. Actually, he was a fearful-looking creature. It was as though Satan had incarnated himself and stood right in front of me as I preached. But what a joy to give out the powerful gospel message right over that dear old man's head. How marvelous to see the power of Christ dominate not only that poor old Hindu, but hundreds of other equally weird and superstitious people in our midst. I preached on Mark 9:23, urging them to only believe. Thousands did believe, and when I finished my message, we called upon them to accept Christ, and it looked as though everyone raised his hand into the air to receive the Savior. It was overwhelming, a sea of hands, a tidal wave response. As it was in the Bible, multitudes were added to the Lord. Then we prayed for all the sick. When finished, we've seldom seen anything like it. Literally, hundreds were miraculously healed and began trying to reach the platform. The first one up the steps was an old Hindu man carrying two crutches above his head. He was beaming. His long hair and beard were flowing. For 5 years he'd been crippled. Now he paraded back and forth so happy. By that time, another old man with a large red turban came bounding across the platform. He, too, was healed completely. A man whose foot and leg were crippled was perfectly healed. He had walked on one side of his foot, which was turned directly inward, with the ankle twisted over. Both feet were perfectly healed and perfectly straight. He ran and jumped as the people glorified God. Two men who were blind came to the crusade together. Both of them were healed. Their eyes were so bright and clear that one could hardly believe that they had been blind. Oh, they were so happy. A child with one arm bent double so that he never had been able to stretch it out was perfectly healed. He was so happy. Two boys who were brothers, both of them totally blind, came and both were healed. It was a most wonderful sight to see them look at each other and rub each other's face in admiration. Then a little girl was healed of blindness and could see everything. Then a 70-year-old woman who had been nearly blind for 7 years was healed, and she could see everything clearly. A most touching thing, a little old woman clad in a dirty, filthy garb testified in tears. She would praise Jesus, then place her open palms together and bow to me in Hindu fashion. Then she would bow to my feet and touch them, then repeat it again and again. She had been a beggar and had no one to help her. Her children and her husband were dead. She was left alone in life to beg. She said that she had become terribly sick until she was too weak to beg. Each day that she could not beg, she had no way to get a bit of rice, so she became sicker and hungrier and consequently weaker. Then she would cry and touch my feet again and say how thankful she was that she was not lying in the bushes anymore, sick and hungry. Someone had found her in her dying state and had told her about Jesus and about this meeting. Somehow she had managed to come. Now Jesus was her friend and she was healed. Now, she said, I can go back on the street and beg because I'm not sick and weak. I can talk loud enough to ask for alms and get a few paises a day to eat. Oh, it was touching. How thankful we are to have come to India just for her. There were at least 20 blind people healed tonight. My wife counted 6 people healed of crossed eyes. Numerous cripples and lame people walked. Several deaf mutes were healed. All praise be to the Lord Jesus Christ.
February 21st, 1963, Manila, Philippines.
Tonight was a very wonderful service. The multitude here in Manila, Philippines was large. I preached on 4 steps to healing, closing with great emphasis on the fact that salvation includes healing and that to receive healing, one must receive the healer. The Lord surely confirmed his word to the people as they cried out to God for salvation. Then we prayed for the sick, and God really confirmed his word. A man who had been deaf for over 30 years was healed. A woman who was deaf for 10 years was healed completely. A child, healed of polio, took off its steel leg brace and shoe and walked perfectly. A lady was healed of a large goiter. It disappeared. A woman with one leg 2 inches shorter than the other felt God's power go through her leg, and both legs were perfectly equal. Another woman was healed of a goiter and a blood disease. It was an outstanding case. A man carried both of his crutches above his head as he came to the platform and testified, "He can walk as well as anyone." A man who had a cancerous growth on the side of his neck the size of 2 fists was perfectly healed. They had sent him home from the hospital to die. Nurses were afraid to touch him. The huge growth simply disappeared. It was astounding. He walked back and forth, pounding the side of his neck, shouting, "Look, it's gone, it's gone, the cancer is gone." One of the missionaries knew the case and was amazed. The pastor of Bethel Temple grabbed me and said in tears, "He's been staying in our church. We know how he was. The cancer's gone. It was as big as 2 fists, and it was open and odorous, sore. It's gone. It's amazing." What a tremendous miracle, and what a tremendous meeting. Scores of great miracles took place. The multitude will never forget what they saw tonight.
April 14th, 1965, San Fernando, Trinidad, West Indies.
The crusade here in San Fernando, Trinidad, in the West Indies, has been one of the greatest we've ever seen in our lives. Literally, the entire city has been attracted to hear the gospel. Upwards of 50,000 to 75,000, perhaps even 100,000 people have poured onto the great crusade grounds at the edge of the city from all over the island nation. Tonight, I preached on what Jesus did for every individual at the cross. I emphasized his substitutionary work for each one and stressed Romans 1:16, that the gospel is now the power of God to everyone that believes. When I finished the message and gave an invitation to accept Christ, at least 5,000 people raised their hands to believe on Jesus Christ and to receive him as their Savior. Then we prayed for the sick, and there was an avalanche of miracles. All over the crowd, rejoicing could be heard, and one could see people here and there throughout the crowd being healed. At the edge of the crowd, groups were running after different ones who had received miraculous healing. Before we knew it, the platform was being inundated with people who wanted to testify of what God had done for them. They were shouting, praising God. Some were jumping. Others were crying. A young man was weeping and rubbing his eyes. His left eye had been badly crossed, and he was nearly blind. Twice he had undergone surgery to straighten the crossed eye and to restore his sight, but both operations had failed. Tonight, his blind crossed eye was completely restored. Then an old woman touched me on the arm, wanting to testify. For over 3 years, her right eye had been totally blind. She was completely healed. A 13-year-old lad who had been born deaf was healed. His ears were perfect. A little boy, which had been born crippled, was brought in the arms of its mother. There was no sign of knees or of kneecaps. Both legs were rigid and doubled flat against his chest. Doctors forced the stiff legs down and bound them in casts. The woman attended the crusade and believed for a miracle. The next morning, both legs were normal. Pain was gone, and the child's knees were perfectly formed. Those who knew the child's condition were astonished at this creative miracle. The cast had been cut off of the little legs, and both legs would bend perfectly normal, and the knees were perfectly formed. A dear man was healed of a paralytic stroke which had left him dumb and helpless. His wife had to feed and dress him, but in the meeting tonight, he was completely restored. He could walk, jump, run, and talk normally. It was a great miracle. A dear lad was healed of a totally deaf ear. There was a large scar behind his ears that showed where a radical mastoid operation had been performed, in which his hearing faculties had been removed. God wrought a creative miracle. Now he can hear the faintest whisper. A little boy, whose left eye was totally blind after being hit with a stone on his eyeball, was completely healed. He also had been bitten by a serpent, and his right leg was swollen and painful. But it was also made whole. There was a girl who walked very awkwardly because her left leg was curved in and her foot was twisted. But tonight, the bones in her leg and foot had become perfectly normal and straight. A dear old woman who was totally blind and deaf was healed. Those around her were delighted that her sight had been miraculously restored. A dear man who had come to the crusade hobbling on crutches was made whole tonight. He had prayed to God for his miracle and had been completely restored. Another dear man was carried to the crusade on a bed because he was paralyzed and unable to move his legs. He was instantly healed. He got up from his bed and began to walk, swinging his arms and moving his hands. He was perfect. An old woman who'd been totally blind for several years was led to the great campaign. She listened intently to the message of the gospel and believed on Jesus Christ. And during the healing prayer, she placed her hand on her blind eyes, then acted her faith. Her sight was restored, and she was overwhelmed at being able to see clearly again. There was a woman who had been totally deaf for 32 years. During the prayer, her ears popped open. She could hear the faintest whisper. A beautiful lad about 12 years old was healed in his legs. One leg was twisted inward, and the foot was malformed. Some might call it a club foot. He walked on the side of his foot, and the knee was twisted inward. With childlike faith, this lad asked God to heal him as we prayed for the mass of people, and he received a creative bone miracle. The club foot was straightened out. His leg that had been twisted was made also perfectly whole. Perhaps the greatest miracle of all was the healing of Harold Kahn, who is a Muslim lad reared in a Muslim home. When he was only 12 years old, he was injured while playing football. His right leg was damaged so that all growth stopped abruptly. An incurable bone disease resulted, affecting his left leg too. Harold is 14 now, and since the accident, his body has grown as any robust youth, except for his right leg, which never developed after the injury. It had already become 5.5 inches shorter than the left one and was proportionally smaller. Harold walked with the aid of a special shoe for his dwarfed right leg, elevated on a 5.5-inch platform. His left leg was bound in a steel hip to heel brace because of the bone disease which affected it. News reached the Kahn home of the campaign. Mrs. Kahn wanted to take Harold, but was forbidden by the staunch Muslim father. But while he was away, she took her son at the risk of family disfavor and attended the great meeting. Both she and her son believed on the Lord Jesus Christ tonight as we expounded the simple, dynamic message on the meaning of the gospel. Before we prayed for the sick, Harold believed that God was seeing him, and he wept before the Lord as he listened to the message. As we were praying, he took off the elevated shoe from his right leg and the steel hip to heel brace from his left leg and accepted Jesus Christ into his heart. Then this awesome miracle came to pass. His short leg became normal as the Lord passed his way. Harold and his mother came weeping to the platform, carrying the steel brace and the elevated shoe. When Harold mounted the steps with this strange elevated shoe in his hand, holding the big leg brace above his head, he was weeping. I presumed that he had come to tell us about someone else who had been healed. I looked at him, and his legs were perfectly normal. I could see no reason for him to have needed this elevated shoe and the big leg brace, so I asked him, "Who's been healed?" He was sobbing convulsively. He finally said, "It's me. It's me. I've been healed. These are the things I've taken off my legs." It was incredible to behold. Pondering that pair of perfectly equal legs, one could but wonder at the awesome power of God to do the utterly impossible. He walked back and forth on the platform, and both of his legs were perfectly equal. It absolutely astounded the multitude of people. Truly, Jesus Christ proved by this awesome miracle that he is the Son of God and is risen from the dead according to the Scriptures. Muslims do not usually believe these things about Christ, but no one could doubt that the Christ of the Scriptures lives today when they saw this wonderful miracle that God had wrought. His father returned to the crusade with the wife and son to give public praise for the miracle that his son had received, and the whole family accepted Christ and became a Christian home. An old woman, 105 years old and totally blind, was led to the crusade. She received her sight. What a miracle of mercy. 105 years old, totally blind, but instantly healed. Truly, there's nothing impossible for God. There were so many other miracles, but I simply haven't the time to record them. All I can say is, truly, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever.
February 26, 1969, Kinshasa, Zaire.
When I take up my pen to record a day like today, I feel helpless to express the glory and wonder of it all. A great multitude heard the word as I preached on Psalms 103, verse 3. No one scarcely moved. They just riveted their attention to each word. When we prayed the prayer of repentance, everyone prayed. There seems to be no opposition. No one refuses. It's just overwhelming to witness this multitude of people here in Kinshasa, Zaire. After the prayer for healing tonight, an avalanche of testimonies converged onto the platform. It was so thrilling. There's no way to record them. It was the same as in Bible days. The dumb and deaf and blind and lame and crazy and sick were all healed. The people cried and laughed and were amazed. As we were terminating the meeting tonight, a mother placed two of her children up on the platform with a bucket. I've never seen anything so precious. These two children reached up to tell me to look. Then they set the bucket on the platform, took off the lid, and pointed. There was a spotless white cloth covering a clean pan with a lid on it. They lifted it out, removed the lid, and there were eight clean, white, fresh eggs. The children smiled sweetly and wanted me to take them. I took my hat and squatted down as the kids placed each egg in the hat, smiled, then replaced their pan in the bucket and put the lid back on it. Then they got up, and the larger one, about 4 years old, reached out to shake my hand, then went back to the edge of the platform to his mother. It was truly a love gift and a tremendous expression of affection. I thank God that we can be among these people. It's a tremendous experience. We quickly ate a roll of bread in the car and drank some fruit water drink, then went to the large hall where 1,200 preachers were waiting for us to share with them the secrets of evangelism.
December 10, 1974, Benin City, Nigeria.
This is an enormous crusade in this city whose history is so steeped in pagan culture and primitive superstition. 50,000 or more are attending each of the meetings. Tonight I preached on Romans 1:16, the gospel. I was able to really convey the message of the good news and was under an unusual anointing as I told them at the finale, "My government in heaven has authorized me as an ambassador in Christ's name to announce to every sinner who believes in what Christ did at the cross that you will never be condemned by your sins, that you are now forgiven." And then I continued, I said, "I am authorized to pronounce that every captive is free, to announce to all sick people that you are healed and that Satan no longer reigns with authority in your lives if you believe on Jesus Christ. I am sent from God with a special proclamation, and I have orders to tell all captives of sin, disease, and devils that the term of your captivity is ended, and that you may now walk out of bondage as free persons, saved and healed by Jesus Christ, God's Son." Needless to say, hundreds did walk out of bondage. And in all directions, spontaneous outbursts of praise and excitement could be seen as cripples suddenly began to walk and as people began to realize they were healed. Great glory was given to God, and all believed that Jesus truly was among them. The message was clearly grasped, and a great wave of reverence gripped the people as they repented of sins and receive Jesus Christ. It was a powerful night, and the many thousands present could easily witness the great signs and wonders which God did among them to confirm His word. The platform was simply inundated by hundreds pushing and crying and rejoicing, wanting to tell what God had done for them. There's no way I could record the scores and scores of great testimonies from just tonight. A girl who was born with no vaginal opening was brought last night and was healed. Today they came and told us that she's now normal. It's a very unusual case. A boy wept as he confessed that he was a thief. Now he says he will never steal again. A lad testified whose right heel had never touched the ground because his knee was bent. He had to walk on his tiptoe. He was perfectly healed. His leg became straight, and the foot was flat on the floor. Then a boy came who had one leg quite a bit shorter than the other. He, too, was absolutely perfect and walked with a true, even stride. It amazed everyone. A woman threw away two canes with which she had staggered along for 17 years. Also, for over 7 years, she had vomited nearly all of her food. Tonight, she was totally restored. She walked perfectly, and her stomach was completely healed. A man came carrying two heavy sticks. For years, he had only been able to stagger along by bracing himself with these two canes. Now he tossed those heavy sticks away and walked as well as anyone. An old blind woman was healed. She could see everything and was so happy. A young woman with one blind eye was completely recovered. At least three deaf mutes were healed, and many who were deaf in one or two ears were restored. We examined so many that we finally had to say, "Praise the Lord," and just pass them on. It's impossible to tell how great God's presence and power was. We just give Him the glory. Tonight we have beheld the glory of God in a way seldom seen. The newspaper estimates that at least 200,000 were present. How merciful is our God to these dear people to descend among them and perform such wonders. I preached on the healing of the leper in a narrative style, expounding as I read the story. Each time I emphasized a point, the multitude would break out in clapping. All of the region around here seems to be receptive to the crusade. As usual, we directed them in a prayer for salvation, accepting Jesus Christ and confessing faith in Him. Hundreds wept freely. It's very touching to see such a mass of them and to hear them weep and pray. You could see different ones smiting themselves on their breast, as the sinner did in the Bible. God must be moved with great compassion when He sees a multitude like this crying out to Him for mercy. After a long period of prayer and thanksgiving, I began to announce to them that it was time to accept the answer by faith and to put faith into action. Some most remarkable miracles took place tonight. A handsome lad, about 15 years old, had been deaf since he was 2 years old when he had had a bad fever. Tonight, he could hear the faintest whisper and my wristwatch from either ear. Suddenly, a dear man mounted the stage, looking so happy. He had crawled on his hands and feet in a pitiful way. His knees had been stiff. It seemed that a deadening, stiffening paralysis, mixed with perhaps arthritis, had crippled him. His hands had been twisted and gnarled. To show us how he had managed to move about, he bent over and walked across the platform on his hands and feet. It was really sad, but then he rose to his feet and raised both arms heavenward and praised the Lord in such a precious way that hundreds of us wept for joy. He could now walk, bending his legs, and do anything in a normal way. He was really made whole, a wonder of God. The multitude cheered and clapped for joy. The next one who testified was quite an old man, who for the past 8 years had only been able to move about by scooting on his haunches with his hands at his side. He pushed himself along in a most painful way. He showed us on the platform how he did it. Then the dear old man rose to his feet and showed everyone how he can now walk upright, which he hadn't done for 8 years. Oh, he was so grateful. Then a dear woman bounded up the other side of the platform crying, "Look at me! I was a leper! See my feet? Now I'm healed! Look at me walk! Look! My feet are healed! I can feel them! They are well! I'm healed!" It was a marvel of God. She stomped her feet. Some of her toes had been gone. There had been angry, open sores on them, but they were clearly drying up and closing. She was overjoyed. She left crying out, "I'm healed. My feet are healed. I can feel them. They're not dead. They're alive." No one could doubt what God had done for that woman. Then a man came who had been totally blind for several years. He was able to see everything. Next, a woman who'd been blind came rejoicing because she could see everything clearly too. She had been led to the crusade. Now she was rejoicing. As she pointed out all the people, she could count the fingers of anyone who raised his hand out in the audience. It was marvelous. A dear mother brought her child, which had had one side paralyzed by polio. She was crying and thanking God because the child was healed and could run and jump and walk perfectly. Then an older man who'd been a witch doctor came up the steps. He was ashamed of the curses he had put on people and the deaths that he had caused. Now he wanted to receive Jesus so that he would never be a witch doctor again. "I commanded the evil spirits of witchcraft to leave him and never to torment or possess him again." The people were astonished. And then, as though someone had defeated a great enemy, they cried out in joy and clapped for a long time. It was touching. The old man was clearly delivered, and everyone marveled. Suddenly, Daisy brought up a young man, about 25 to 28 years old. He was completely bald. For 8 years, he had been a raving maniac. It took 4 men to bring him and to control him during the meeting. He had been in the university at Lagos, the capital of Nigeria, studying medical science. Then one day he suddenly began to lose his mind and became totally insane. A growth began to develop in his left throat and neck area. It was large, like a mango seed, and extremely painful. Tonight, during the mass prayer, he began to be calm. He returned to his absolute normal mind, and every trace of that growth in his throat disappeared. Another man on the platform verified his story. We were all amazed. He spoke good English and was a most brilliant young man. He gave the most moving testimony, explaining how he fell in terror and confusion of mind and began to be compelled to rave and rage and to try to hurt people. Nothing made sense to him anymore, and he felt that everyone was trying to harm him. He became mad. Now he says everything is so clear and normal. He's amazed that all of the terror that had tormented his mind is gone. He thanked Jesus and pledged to serve him always. Really, the case was marvelous, and we glorified God. Then I turned to see a man coming up the steps who had been a leper. He was overwhelmed that the deadness of his feet and his hands were gone. His hand had become motionless, drawn to a clenched position and stiff. But now he could open and close them well. Every finger was free. He could feel with his feet and his hands. He was amazed and overjoyed and kept on praising God. An elderly man came up the steps with a long staff. He was surprised and so happy. He said that he had been operated on for his back and hip and had never walked since the operation 6 years ago. He was helped to the crusade by friends, but got there late, just as we began the prayer. When the prayer was finished, he could stand up and walk with no trouble and with no pain. He was overwhelmed. All were thankful to see how God's mercy reached out to this dear old man. A young man about 20 years of age came and said, "I was mad. I was crazy. But now I am healed." We were all amazed by these words. He looked so nice. We wondered if his story was true. So I asked for his name. He announced his name over the loudspeaker. Then I asked if anyone knew him. Suddenly some hands raised. I asked them to come to the platform. A fellow came and said, "I know him. It's true. He was crazy. We had to hold him at times. He's been like that for several years." They marveled. He was absolutely sane, normal, radiant, and sensible looking. He talked calmly and coherently. One simply stood amazed at the glory and the mercy of God. An old woman who had been crippled in her back for many years came to testify. She hadn't been able to stand upright, always walking humped over, supporting her back by bracing her hands above her knees. Now she stood perfectly erect, reared back and forward and sideways. Then she waved her arms. She was healed by a perfect miracle. A middle-aged woman who had been blind was led to the meeting, and now she's received clear sight. She could obviously see everything. Suddenly, a man about 40 to 45 years of age came to testify. As he talked, I heard gasps in the audience and expressions of wonder. My interpreter was so awestricken that he quit interpreting. I nudged him to keep translating for me. He said, wait, what is this? What is this? He was amazed. I had to insist to get him to tell me what the man was saying. Then the man stretched out his arms with wrists upturned, placing them close together, and I saw big scars and tough calluses on his wrists. Then he showed the people his ankles. They were the same. There were big calluses around his ankles. I asked the interpreter, "What is this? Tell me." He said, "Oh, this can't be true. This can't be true." Then he explained that the man for 11 years had been crazy and possessed by demons. They had to keep his feet and his hands in iron bands with chains. They had kept him locked in a mud hut. He would fight and try to kill people. No one could get close to him, so he had to be kept in iron bands. Again, a preacher said, "This can't be so." I asked, "Then why are those scars on his wrists? And look at his ankles. They're worse." Deep calluses circled his ankles that told the awful story. The dear man looked and seemed so normal that it was difficult to believe that he had ever been insane. So I asked for someone in the multitude who knew him. Promptly a woman came through the crowd, excited and crying. She was shouting, "I know him. I live by the place where they kept him chained and locked up." He screamed. He was dangerous. He tried to kill people. To change his clothes or to feed him, they had to fight with him. Then the dear man interrupted the woman and opened his mouth wide, pointing at his teeth. Some of his teeth were gone. He said, "They beat me and kicked out my teeth." It was sad, yet it was glorious to behold. The man was so normal that it was hard to believe he had been a dangerous, raving maniac. The woman kept talking and thanking God for the wonder of his healing. The man was truly delivered. Obviously, the tormenting demons had gone out of him as we had preached the word and prayed for the multitude, and he was healed like they were healed in the multitudes when Jesus preached the word and cast out the demons with his word. Who could doubt the glory and mercy of God after witnessing such an avalanche of miracles, signs, and wonders? I could write for hours and not recount what happened tonight. The stories are endless. People were healed everywhere. The platform was full of people who had been healed. All across the field of people, hundreds raised their hands to signify that they were healed, but they couldn't get through the press of multitude to testify. It's truly amazing, as it was in Bible days, when Jesus saw the multitude and was moved with compassion toward them and healed their sick. He is truly the same yesterday and today and forever for those who will have simple, childlike faith and take him at his word without theological calculations and psychological analysis. Thank God for the simplicity and the reality of his word.
December 17, 1977, Nakuru, Kenya.
Amazing things are taking place in this city. The whole town is talking. We're hearing of amazing things that took place last night. At the far edge of the crowd, a woman who was born blind and had never seen in her life was suddenly healed. As she began to see, she became so frightened that she screamed aloud and started to run. Then she saw a car moving. It horrified her, and she became frantic. She was just a poor village woman who had never seen in her life. Seeing the masses of people moving about, she was horrified. Her husband called to her to calm her. She knew his voice and turned to him, but seeing him coming toward her, she screamed and turned and ran. They finally caught her and held her until they could help her overcome the shock of new eyesight. Zachariah Jikohi, a leading Christian businessman, saw it all. Then another blind woman was sitting in a car at the edge of the multitude. The husband was standing by the rear of the car. His wife was totally blind. And when the prayer was finished, the woman opened her eyes, and her blindness was absolutely gone. She was so shocked and overwhelmed that she shouted out loud, almost fearfully, and jumped out of the car and called for her husband. When he rushed to her and saw what had happened, he fell on his face to the ground, weeping and crying out loud. Ismail, one of the main ushers, and many local Christians saw it and verified it as she came to testify. Then over at another area, Ishmael, who operates one of the mobile evangelism units we've placed in Kenya, had been watching a lad with terribly crippled feet. They turned up so that he walked on the sides of his ankles. All of a sudden, after the prayer, the boy's feet straightened out, and he could stand upright on them. Both feet were flat, and he was healed. Ishmael took him and tried for over an hour to get the lad to the platform, but couldn't even get near, so great was the press of the multitude. The boy will come today and testify. Pastors have been coming to our room all day with new reports of miracles that are taking place. The Finnish missionary here, with two of our interpreters, came into our room almost out of breath. They said that over on Kolingan Street, the police are having to forcibly open a way through the crowd in the street so the cars can pass. A 4-year-old child who was born totally blind received sight last night, and the street is jammed by people who are amazed. The mother has the child over there showing everyone. What is overwhelming to the people is that many of them know the child and confirm the mother's words, that it was born with a white film over its eyes so thick that it seemed like a skin. Now that film has disappeared, and the child is clearly seeing everything. While I've been writing this, they brought the child to the hotel for us to see, and it's absolutely amazing what's happening to that little boy's eyes. It's a creative miracle without doubt. One of the hotel men came and said to Daisy's interpreter, "I must go today and get my wife from the village. I was standing in the meeting last night and my own eyes witnessed a great miracle. A woman who was born blind suddenly received her sight. She screamed and tried to run from everyone and from everything that moved, and they had to catch her and hold her. I saw it with my own eyes. Oh, I never thought I would ever see something so wonderful as this." It was the same woman I described before. Then one of the missionaries pointed out of the hotel window to a woman who was sitting on the wall by the road out in front of our hotel. A group was with her. "We just received word of her miracle last night. She had been crippled in both legs and could barely manage to move about. Her knees were bent and turned inward so that they had to be forced around each other when she would take one step after the other. She could scarcely walk at all. She had to shuffle herself by moving her legs below her knees, balancing her weight with a heavy stick. Last night, the woman was healed. God literally straightened her bones. They brought her to the hotel to show us the miracle, and it's absolutely awesome. Her legs are well. It was a marvel to see the woman showing the crowd that gathered around the hotel what God had done for her. Her legs are restored. They're normal." The first miracle that reached the platform last night was a lad with crutches and steel leg braces. He and his mother came to the hotel today and gave us the most wonderful testimony. The boy was a healthy 11-year-old lad who went to school. Then he was in a car accident. His right leg was broken above the knee. After the cast was removed, he fell and broke it again and broke the left leg too. They put both legs in casts up to his waist. Then they discovered that he had a bone disease which made his bones brittle and weak. For 3 months, the lad lay flat in bed. In boarding school, he was finally able to walk again by using 2 crutches. Then he fell and broke his right leg again. One more time, he spent 3 months in a cast. This time, the feeling in his leg was gone, and it seemed to be dead. A crippling paralysis had set in, and there seemed to be no life in his legs. Again, he was put on crutches, but both legs had to be fitted to steel braces. Even so, he could hardly swing his legs around. Without the supports, he could not bear weight or take a step. But last night, he took off his braces and handed his crutches to his mother, who gave them to me. Then the lad walked all over the platform, back and forth, while the multitude marveled. Oh, how happy he was! Today his joy is even greater, as every hour he's gaining strength. Praise the Lord. We're really seeing Bible days. I wonder what else we'll hear about before this day is over. By the time we arrived at the crusade field around 4:30 in the afternoon, it was filling up with people. By the time I began preaching, there must have been 40 to 60,000 people at least who were present. Every road leading toward us was a literal river of human beings pouring into the grounds. I preached on blind Bartimaeus, then dealt thoroughly with the multitude about salvation and receiving Jesus Christ. What an experience to lead such a multitude in prayer to be saved. I wish the whole world, especially Christians of the world, could experience what we saw today and what we've been seeing for 3 decades in 60 different nations already. No words can describe the sacred and powerful atmosphere and the presence of Jesus when a great multitude cries out to him for salvation. Literally thousands and thousands were absolutely converted today, and there was such joy in the city. It was like Bible days when Philip preached in the city of Samaria. There's just no way to tell the wonder of it all. After urging them to follow Jesus and to go to church, and after urging the pastors to give the people a chance to testify, then we instructed them about healing and prayed for them to be healed. Then we led them in a thorough confession of thanks, of faith, and of acceptance of healing. Then I asked them to put their faith into action, to begin to do what they couldn't do before the prayer. I must here testify that I don't believe we have seen the equal before, at least certainly not often. It seemed that the healing power of God literally exploded across the field, and in every section of the multitude, groups at the far edge started running, following cripples who had been healed or who had taken off braces or tossed crutches aside and had begun to walk or run. The field was an explosion of joy. It was one of the most heavenly scenes we've ever witnessed. Just about the time I was getting ready to ask them to come to the platform, a lad burst up the ramp carrying 2 crutches in one hand and 2 braces with shoes on them in the other. That dear lad was so marvelously healed. Just as I was trying to calm the audience to explain the case, a girl about 15 years old bounded up the ramp from the other side, past the excited photographers, carrying 2 large braces and walking almost perfectly normal. There I was, with 2 crutches and 4 leg braces and shoes, trying to get the audience quieted down enough to explain these miracles. Then I saw them handing braces and crutches over the heads of the people, passing them toward the platform in 4 places at a time. About that time, the multitude realized what was happening, and things went wild. They rushed a woman up the right side of the platform, carrying 2 crutches and 1 brace above her head. She had been healed, too, and was weeping for joy. Then someone yelled, "Look here!" A woman whose eyes seemed wild with excitement came yelling and crying, carrying 2 hip-to-foot braces with shoes on them, and we tried to have her testify. She kept looking about wildly, and finally she said, "It's not me, it's my daughter. She was healed. She took off those braces and began to run, and I've lost her. Can you help me find her? Daughter, where are you?" And she began calling for her daughter. It was pandemonium everywhere, as you could see people with crutches and canes and braces waving them in the air in no less than 12 places at once. Groups could be seen breaking out of the press, running as someone was healed on the edge of the crowd. The platform by this time was literally overrun with miracles, and yet it kept increasing. A pastor pressed through frantically with 2 crutches above his head. He saw a man throw them down and turn around and start running as the people had opened up a way before him. The pastor hadn't been able to get on the platform, and this had happened when he was standing out in the audience. We called for the man, but couldn't get things quieted down enough to find him. A youth bounded up the ramp among the crowd of healed cripples that was on the platform. He had been born deaf and dumb, and the lad could repeat every word we pronounced. He even heard the tick of a watch. When the crowd realized it, it was amazing. I was trying to explain it all when a mother, carrying two crutches high above her head, came rushing up the ramp and across the platform, walking as well as I can. Then a lady who was deaf and dumb and who had had spastic paralysis came, looking almost wild with excitement. Some pastors knew her. Now she was completely healed. She could clearly repeat every word I pronounced, and by the time we finished checking her, her twisted, contortive muscles were relaxed. Her eyes were filled with amazement as she discovered that she could move her arms and hands up and down, double and straighten them with no more spasms. It was an awesome wonder to behold. By this time, there was such hilarious joy and boundless happiness that we simply could no longer control things. All the ramps, both sides and at the back, were jammed with miracles. When I asked how many more out in the field were healed but could not come forward, probably 2,000 hands were raised and waved as they praised the Lord to affirm that they also were healed, but that they couldn't get to the platform to testify. It would take a great book to begin to recount the wonders of God wrought this night. Witnessing this day, I can only say, to God be the glory. I thank Him again for letting Daisy and me experience yet another such wondrous day after 30 years of it like that. Amen.